30-year in lone voice, more or less, in the wilderness, opposing appeasement by 1940, the Prime Minister, who saved not just Britain and its empire, but I think really saved Western civilization. So when one looks at history from my vantage point, the thing that leaps out is that economics is not all-powerful, it's not all-dominant. And sometimes it is morale, it is culture that dominates. If economics predicted all wars' outcomes, then the United States would have won the Vietnam War handily. So would have won the Korean War handily.
In the context of China, then, how does China fare when it comes to culture, putting aside the economic issues, the tariff issues, and so forth? Does it fare well or not?
Well, if you go, as I frequently do, to China and listen to Chinese academics or political figures, they nearly always begin their speeches by saying that their civilization is thousands of years old, has this extraordinary strength and continuity, and therefore you newbies who only just created your republic in 1776 should be intimidated. But this is all really rather implausible, because in reality, Chinese history is a history of great upheaval, of turmoil. The biggest war of the 19th century was not the American Civil War, than any other war. It was the Taiping Rebellion in China. And the rebellion's upheavals have characterized Chinese history. The most recent was, of course, the revolution that produced the communist regime we know today. That was only in 1949. They're a long way from being able to celebrate even their 100th birthday. And I think if one spends time listening to China's leaders a little bit more carefully, you realize that they feel insecurity. Not with respect to the outside world, about which I think they're quite confident, they feel insecure about their own domestic situation, because they know that after all the upheavals of the Mao years and then the meteoric growth that followed Deng Xiaoping's coming to power, their legitimacy depends primarily on delivering growth. It's the fact that they've taken hundreds of millions of ordinary Chinese out of poverty that keeps the Communist Party in power. Not any great ideological commitment to communism as an ideology, because everybody knows that it's just something that the leadership pays lip service to. Everybody knows that the party had become extraordinarily corrupt as a result of the enormous amounts of money that were being generated. So I think there's insecurity there, and that's the thing that we foreigners often misunderstand about China.
We'll be right back.
We get USAA insurance for members like King. A former Army medic made of the flexibility to handle whatever Monday has in store and tackle four things at once. So when her car got hit, she didn't worry. She simply filed a claim on her USAA app and said,
I've got this.
USAA insurance has made the way Kate needs it easy. She can even pick her payment plan, so it's easy on her budget and her life.